Well, hello, my YouTube friend. Today, it is my utter pleasure to present you this beautiful, beautiful, obviously beautiful little knife that I have here. To me, it's truly a masterpiece from a young knife maker, Mr. Edison Barracas, also known as Shark Knifeco. So, a word about this maker, but first of all, I wanted to make an overview leaving all my fingerprints on those materials that are polished to the highest level, and those will take my fingerprints probably better than any agent of the FBI. So before that, I wanted you to have the opportunity to see how exquisite this knife is. This is a true work of art for me, and I'm going to present you that knife. And first of all, a word about his maker. So Edison Shark Knifeco started making knives not so long ago, like a couple of years, I would say. You know him probably. You have seen his crazy and bold design with the multi-grind blade. Man, those squared blade, crazy shape. To me, they gave me some kind of headaches because I liked like bold knives, but those knives, man, it was probably too much. But Edison is like that. He's an artist, and the thing that I always liked him for that, because he was unique with his already spoiled zirconian. Sorry about that. He's unique with his craziness. I mean, who did those kind of multi-grind, shaped blade? Man, his design, just check his page and you will see. They were totally nuts. but I loved that uniqueness, because a lot of people, do several design. You cannot point out and say, oh yeah, this is coming from this. Of course, you have designs that are very linked to one guy, but most of the time you're gonna have some regular shape and everything. So he was going out of this regular thing with his craziness. Then I met the guy at the Miami show. Actually, it was in March, late March, last March. What a great guy. I mean, absolutely, absolutely fantastic guy. Just a sweetheart. And I truly, from that point, I really wanted to own one of his knives, because, how it is. I told you about that. I like to have knives from people I respect and like. And this guy, immediately I liked him, and I wanted to have a knife from him. But, respect also is owning a piece from a maker that you would respect, and you would respect the piece as you would respect the maker. And through the piece, you will respect the maker. So getting this crazy knife from him wouldn't have been any respectful, because just the design I didn't like. That's it. But then after that, he started making, more regular shape. I started to think, that, oh man, eventually I will definitely get a knife from him. But still, he was doing only flippers, And we discussed, and, along the road, he said, oh, one day I will try non-flipper. I will try, a knife that wouldn't be a flipper. I'd like that. And I said, the day you do a non-flipper and a knife with a kind of regular shape, I'll take it, let me know, I'll take it. So he decided to do that. And to be honest with you, I don't know if you remember that I made that inquiry. But he decided to make his first non-flipper. So this is actually his first non-flipper. All Shark Knifeco's knives to date were only flipper. So yeah, he decided to make that non-flipper, dual thumb stabs. And since the guy is a crazy nut, just deciding to make an overall regular shape, because how more regular than that can it be? I mean, we're going to see that there's more to it than this simple grind as it could seem. But for him, that's just, oh man, simplicity. I'm not talking about the hand rub or whatever, but just the grind itself looks so simple for him, you know. So maybe he went like donkers, you know, bonkers. And to him, it was too simple to go with a grind like that. So he decided to go crazy on the handle. And this, my friend, is, oh man, I appreciate that so much because I like craziness, but I like craziness that I can appreciate. So craziness on a handle, I can deal with that. And having a nice and simple blade shape like this one, I really appreciate that. So overall, having a knife from him, his first non-flipper, some craziness, but I can afford here, and some really delicate grind here. Man, I couldn't be happier than that. So let's start about the craziness, and then after that, we're going to go to the blade. So this is absolutely, absolutely craziness. Listen, first of all, the idea itself is just fantastic. Mixing and with an alternative pattern like that, superconductor, as I said, zirconium, etc., as I said, and on the other side, the same. Look at that, the color in superconductor, zirconium, whatever. It's just insane. But that's, I mean, it's not it. It's like, you know what, the visible part of the iceberg. The more, this is what you see, what you can see. But the craziness is what you cannot see. And what you cannot see here is that this knife, and I'm going to try to focus. Yeah, you can see it from here. See the scale, see the liners. You're going to see this space there. So basically what we have here is a knife. Oh yeah, you can see here also there. Is a knife that has all his external pieces are floating. So if you check inside, you're going to see, maybe you're going to see, I'm going to try to focus here, that there are a lot of screws there. There are 89 pieces that makes this knife. So you have a lot of screws that are screwed from the liner to the scale, and you have all those kind of bridges that you can see in between the scale and the liners that makes a floating knife. I've seen, you know, during G7, the knife from, look here, I mean, the space between the scale and the liner, please say that. That's just crazy. During G7, Todd Rexford, I mean, one of his most crazy knife was crazy because of that, because he did some floating liners, overlays, and that was just insane. Edison here made a full scale with floating scales, overlays, call them whatever you want. I'm sorry, I almost lost my voice because I'm still speechless about the craziness. And so that's what you see. You might think that this is the most crazy, but this is the most crazy. All the knife is floating. Even the backspacer here is floating. I'm gonna try to focus on this one just for you to see. Let me see. Wait a minute here. Why not? I don't know why with the angle you don't see it, but it's floating, believe me. There is a space definitely between the piece of superconductor and the zirconium here. Why? Oh yeah, you see here, you see it, this one here, but the camera, yeah, you can tell now, okay? Even the backspacer is floating. Now look at this clip. Those are, you could, first of all, when he showed me that clip, I thought that, you know, this and this were kind of glued on a kind of spacer, but not at all. Those are two intricate pieces. So you have, let me try to show you that, if I can. Okay, I won't. I won't. So basically, underneath this piece of superconductor, there is, he drilled a kind of space, and this is intricated in it, and the two screws are holding the two pieces together through those two standoffs. 89, as I said, 89 pieces were used to make this knife. So that build right there is absolute craziness. I mean, there is so much to say. Look at that. Look at this insert of zirconium here. The color there. There is so much to say about this build that I listen, just imagine the complexity of this build. And there is even more than what you can imagine there. So that's just great, insane. And I couldn't thank enough, Edison, to let me have this knife under my care. Absolutely insane. Look at all the details here, the line here of the bolster that will follow the line here that you have on the clip. Everything is well thought. Now let's go and discuss about the knife itself. So the centering is absolutely perfect, and you can tell that the blade is following the line in between the two pieces of the backspacer. Absolutely spot on. Now the action. So as I told you, Edison knows mainly flippers, so his detent is going to be probably more closer to a flipper detent than a thumb stud. So this is his first, and he went for the detent that he knows. Look at that. Oh, one thing I didn't mention. Look at the blackness that he got with the titanium. Not a lot of people master the art. Oh, yeah, you can tell the backspacer is floating here. I'm losing it, sorry. So not a lot of people masters the blackening of titanium. And man, is that a blackened titanium. He didn't want, you know, to leave here something like, you know, the regular gray that would contrast too much probably with the black that he got. Even the black that he got with the zirconium is black. It's black. Most of the time when you get a zirconium, you're going to have some kind of dark gray, you know, but this is black. This is absolutely the non-color black is what I have in front of me here. That is the blackest of the blackest zirconium I've ever seen. And I've held quite a few, believe me. So even that is incredible. So now the liners, as I said, really well blackened here. Look at that. It's absolutely fantastic. Fantastic. The jimping here is insane. Thumb stud here in zirconium, thumb stud here, sorry, in superconductor, of course. So look at this engagement here. Perfect. No stickiness whatsoever to disengage. It's unbearing. It's smooth as they can come. Here that detent. Clock. And man, it's addictive. You know, you want to flick that knife open. The action is absolutely splendid. The detent is quite strong, but as I said, he's coming from flipper, so that's a regular. If you want to open it delicately, it's well balanced. I absolutely recant on what I say. The detent is absolutely perfect for a smooth opening like that, or for a flicking action. It's just perfect. Now let's go and talk about the blade a little bit. So the grind might seem simple, but there is no more complicated than to do a big flat coming here from the spine up until the edge. It's look at the thickness of this blade. And it's consistent. It goes here to an edge here that is really, really thin, and it cuts like hell. It cut me already. It's razor sharp. So having, I don't know if you know that, my friend, but having a consistent flat here, it's way more difficult, way more difficult to obtain that a hollow grind and a compound crazy grind. So this is really difficult to obtain a really nice flat like that. Here, as you can see, it's not like there is here, you see I don't know how to call that, but you know, it's not like following all the line like that. You see, there is a kind of, yeah. Oh man, sorry, I'm losing words here, but you see what I mean? It's not like only, you know, straight. You have here, boom. I'm gonna find my words later. I don't know when the video will be finished, probably. So, look at this line here. It's very, very refined line. There is no swedge here, but I really like, look at that. I mean, this line is just absolutely excellent. A little word, because you have here the HD and you can tell that the hand rubbed is perfectible. You have to understand that it's probably his fourth or fifth knife in hand rubbed, and hand rubbing a knife is a matter of training. So this is nothing. The artistry is got everything. The talent is got it all. The only thing that he needs to improve a little bit is it's the hand rub, but that is nothing. Man, I'm heading to the 15 minutes and I don't want to go over that. So let me tell you that this knife is absolutely awesome. And I cannot be happier than I am with this knife. I want to thank Shark Nifco and also to congratulate him for this endeavor. This is truly what in the ancient time we would call a masterpiece. And on that words, my friend, I'll leave it at that and I'll catch you very soon for another video. Bye-bye.